Why did Bitcoin crash this week? More precisely, why did it seem like Bitcoin crashed this week? If you look at the price chart, the peak was at about $20,000 and the crash was at about $10,000, a little below, I think. Now, if you were flying in an airplane, and it fell from 20,000 feet to 10,000 feet, would you say you had a plane crash? Probably not. You'd say you experienced some turbulence and you lost altitude. It might even be uncomfortable. It might be frightening. But that's no crash. But think about it. How often have you read in the newspapers a headline that said, "A plane lost altitude today"? You just don't hear about it. Turbulence, loss of altitude, it doesn't make the headlines. Only a tragic and dramatic plane crash makes the headlines. Or at the very least, turbulence sufficient enough to make the plane turn around and go back to its originating airport, which did happen with AirAsia a few months ago. Nevertheless, the headline writers are not going to scream about Bitcoin losing some value. They want to scream about Bitcoin crashing. I don't know about you, but a plane crash means going to 0 feet above ground level or minus certain amount of feet below ground level. That's a crash. Going from 20,000 feet to 10,000 feet or even 500 feet is scary, but it's not a crash. But this language is used throughout the stock market. It's used in all markets. People like drama, I guess. And drama's fine if you're going to the theater or you're watching Game of Thrones or Riverdale. But don't let the drama run your life. Look at the truth. Look at reality. Look at that there Bitcoin price chart. Look at this week's so-called crash versus the flat price of half a year ago. Is that a crash? Or is this the trajectory of a plane about to take off?